Tonight on The Bill. Oh, I didn't know she was going to get all intense on me.
That's why people have relationships, isn't it?
What's your name? Mother Teresa?
I expect it'll be a change for you, having a woman in the car.
Nah, I don't think so.
In the front seat, I mean.
Have you got anything on tonight?
Yeah, me pyjamas.
No, well, I've got a bunch of parties for the ex-directory.
I was at that club where you phone up blokes on other tables.
Yeah. Do you fancy it?
Tacky or what?
Lateral's for you, innit, love?
Yeah.
Don't stop on my account.
Well, what's the general consensus then? He's the bastard or I'm the bitch. Come on, I want to hear it.
Actually, Vic, no one said a word.
Really? You're probably all wondering who I'm going to settle on next. Well, I might try someone a little higher up the ladder next time. Superintendent Chandler, maybe? He's probably not so hot between the sheets, but a bigger car and better restaurants. And a girl's got to eat, hasn't she?
Des, Jim, Sierra Oscar 1, ref's at 5:30. Tony, Vicky, you're on Sierra Oscar 2-1.
Short straw again, eh, Vic?
Yeah, well, I've had a few of those recently, haven't I, Sarge? And one or two that bend in the middle.
Oh, aye, mutiny in the ranks.
Can I continue?
If only you'd been able to, not to 60 in 3 seconds, and then the engine cuts right out.
Told you, they're all jellies down here. You want to try some Northern Rock?
More like a penny chew in your case, Des.
Vicky.
Sorry, Sarge, I forgot we're at work now, aren't we? Can I have my CDs back, by the way?
This is going to be a fun shift.
It's always a barrel of laughs for you, Tony, with the emphasis on the barrel, eh?
It's my turn now, is it?
All right, that's enough.
That's what he always says. He's so masterful.
Is there a problem here? Matt?
No problem, sir. Vicky?
No, sir. Not anymore.
It'll blow over.
What would you know about it?
Oh, I've had my moments.
Oh, yeah. And we're not in the 60s anymore, Tony. Why do people feel they have to pile in with advice when a relationship comes to an end? Seems to me they really get off on it, usually because there's nothing happening in their own lives.
All units from Sierra Oscar.
Fenton Street, a robbery.
Just round the corner. We're on.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra 2-1. Go ahead, Vicky.
Yeah, we'll take that, Polly.
You've got to be quicker on the draw than that, Jim. Well, it's not a competition, is it? Never mind, we'll still beat them soon.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra 1. Show's attending too, Polly.
We're nowhere near Fenton Street.
You better shift it then.
You hurt?
No. You just knocked me over. I'll be all right.
I think we better call an ambulance to be safe.
No, I don't want an ambulance.
Oh, he was just coming into my shop. No? I couldn't get out from behind the counter quick enough to do anything.
You're Mr. Hay, are you?
Yes, I'm the owner. Yeah, Archie's a customer of mine.
Archie?
Dodds.
Can you tell me what happened, Mr. Dodds?
Well, this kid attacked me.
Can you give me a description?
No, he jumped me from behind.
I can. He was young, white, could have been more than 15, 16, fair hair, very pale.
Which way did he go?
Up towards Candy Fields.
What was he wearing?
Green jacket and light blue jeans.
What do you take, Mr. Dodds?
Wallet, I expect.
How much was in it?
20 quid, give or take.
Did he take anything else?
No, just the money.
Poaching again, Des?
Too slow off the mark, aren't you?
Yeah. It's like driving around with Noddy.
You all right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Archie, mate, what have you done now?
He's been mugged.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
He's all right. There's no bones broken. Can I come in, Mr...
Warnock. Ian Warnock, of course.
I'm just going to put my feet up, if you don't mind.
Well, you go ahead, Mr. Dodds. I'll need a statement from you later, though.
Yeah, well, you know where I am. Flat 12.
I keep warning them not to take bags out. They're sitting ducks. But they need a shop, don't they? Just like the rest of us, so what can you do?
I heard someone at the door, Ian. I thought it was my daughter.
No, no, she hasn't arrived yet, Elvie.
Why are the police here? Have we been burgled?
No, it's Archie. He's had a bit of an accident.
An accident? That's bad.
No, no, he's all right.
The last time I was burgled, a very nice lady came to see me to talk about it.
Victim support?
No, I think she was from an insurance company, wasn't she, Ian?
Yeah, that wasn't here, though, Elvie, was it? That was at your old house.
They sent me £200 for my Chimes clock.
Did they? Well, I'm sure it was worth at least that.
Oh, it was. Been in the family for years. I do hope I'll get it back. Are you still looking for it?
There's a letter here for you, Elvie.
Is there?
Yeah.
Well, thank you for coming to let me know.
Sorry?
About the clock.
Sierra 2-1 from Sierra Oscar.
Go ahead, Polly.
Yeah, Mr. Hay, the informant from Fenton Street, he's just contacted us again, Vicky.
He thinks he's seen the suspect for the robbery go past his shop again. Can you deal? Thieved. On way.
That should have been our shout. Well, we were tied up, weren't we?
Yeah, helping the aged. So now we've missed a juicy score. Let's go and take a look anyway.
Where'd he go?
Up towards Staley Bridge Road. I'm sure it was him.
Hey! There.
Tony, we can get him.
She looks hurt to me.
We'll come back for her.
No, look, you check and I'll get him.
No!
You all right, love? Get an ambulance. OK, take it easy, police, yeah?
Sierra Oscar from Sierra 2-1. Right, ambulance required, you, yeah? Harrison
police,
Street.
Police, OK?
It's another mugging, Polly.
Look after you, just be...
Suspect still at
nice
large.
And still. Look in your bag, all right? Look at this. Hilda Jenkins, Stalybridge House again.
I'm surprised the fags didn't get her first. It's only just happened. He's running towards Mayola Street.
Why didn't he go after him?
Florence Nightingale.
Oh, come on!
Just face it, Tony, you've gone soft.
Now, how come I'm getting Matthew Boyd in this flat? Why don't you take this out on him? Because it's him you're really speaking to, isn't it? Not me.
This has got nothing to do with him, and you know it.
Well, what is it to do with?
It's to do with you sitting on your fat ass in the car all day.
Look, I wasn't going to leave the old lady in that state just to please you.
To please me? Any copper worth his salt would have gone for the nicking first and foremost. Rules or no rules?
No. But an angry bitch who was spoiling for a rut just because she'd been given the elbow would.
You're a coat hanger for that uniform, Tony. That's all you've been for years.
Now,
right! I'm putting an end to this now.
Sorry, sir, but I can't work with this woman. She's like a polecat.
Better than being a pussycat.
I said that's enough. You both need to cool off. Vicky, you can swap with Jim. And I want you both to report to me at the end of the shift.
Please, darling. Just heard the good news.
Good news? You just got the number one bitch on your team.
Yeah, well, I couldn't have stood do good and Uncle Jim for much longer. Thanks, darling.
Nobody else wants to work with me, you do know that.
I'll take my chances. As long as you stick to the rules.
What rules are they?
My rules.
Don't bank on it, sunshine. I expect it'll be a change for you, having a woman in the car.
Nah, I don't think so.
In the front seat, I mean.
Oh, haha. Do the funnies as well, do you, darling?
Yeah, you better get used to it now, darling. What have you done to her?
What have I done to her?
Looks like you've unleashed a nemesis.
What's that when it's at home?
It's a spirit of vengeance.
I didn't make any promises.
No? Fatal attraction, was it?
If you like.
On whose side?
Hers, of course.
Oh, you just went along with it. Come off it, Matt.
Well, I didn't know she was going to get all intense on me.
Well, that's why people have relationships, isn't it?
What I don't understand is, if she wanted commitment, why did she choose me?
I don't know. Maybe she felt okay being around somebody as insecure as she was.
Spare me the psychology, June. I just want to get shot at the whole thing.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. I stick to 19-year-olds in the future. They're a lot less complicated.
All mouth and no trousers. That's what's wrong with this, Nick.
Couldn't agree with you more. So let's go out and crack a few heads, eh?
It's just what I feel like doing. Must be all the frustration that's been building up the last few days.
Can't get no satisfaction, eh?
You said it. Sticking to chocolate from now on. More reliable.
I reckon you were too much for him.
Sorry.
Boyden. I've met his soul before, pretending they want a relationship just so they can get the leg over. Then once they have, invented some complicated reason why it won't work.
Yep, that's just about the size of it.
Far better to be upfront about it if that's what you want. What's the big deal? Take it or leave it. Now, a relationship, that's for Sunday afternoons as well, isn't it? It's best not to get the two confused. Well, that's my opinion. What do you think?
I think you're spot on, Des. At least as far as Matt Boyden is concerned. That's him.
Who?
Mugger, Fenton Street. He's seen us.
Blues and twos. Put out to all units.
All units from Sierra Oscar 1. Robbery suspect from Fenton Street. Seen entering Trafford Way. Any unit assist?
So, if you do see someone loitering or acting suspiciously, please let Mr. Warnock know, who will contact us. Above all, be safe and thank you for listening.
I think the residents got the message.
Well, let's hope it doesn't intimidate them if they're not going out.
Oh, I doubt it. They're pretty independent. They have to be. We can't do that much for them here.
We will be stepping up our presence over the next few days, but any hint of trouble, just let us know.
Yeah, of course. Excuse me. Evening, Mrs. Bright.
Tried Elvie's buzzer, but she didn't answer.
Oh, she's around earlier. Perhaps she's asleep.
I'm going into the lounge. You come and see your grandma first.
She's asleep.
For once in your life, Nicole, do as you're told.
Elvie's daughter. Single mum. I think Nicole's getting to be a bit of a handful for her.
You must get to know the families quite well.
Oh, yeah. It's an enjoyable part of the job.
Ian, Elvie's not in her flat.
Give us your hand.
I'm here. Okay, up you come. Take it. Up you get.
It's like working with Lara Croft. Have we lost him?
Yeah. Game over.
Well, won't she just be visiting one of the other residents?
She doesn't really get on that well with them.
They don't meet her high standards.
Does she see anyone else apart from the people in the house?
No, not anymore. She comes over to us occasionally, but she doesn't seem to enjoy that very much.
Well, no old friend she could have gone to, anyone like that?
No. I mean, we're about the extent of her world now.
Has she taken anything with her, do you know?
She usually keeps her sponge bag here. Her night is missing too.
So it looks as though she's packed an overnight bag or something.
She's got nowhere to go.
Has been acting strangely lately. Forgetting things and just being more confused than she normally is.
Well, we'll circulate her description. And if she is just wandering around, I'm sure we'll pick her up pretty quickly.
There's a letter here from the Housing Trust. This must have been what arrived this morning. It's confirming a place for her at the Appleton Residential Home.
Looks pretty swish.
She has been finding it difficult to manage here.
Was she expecting this?
Well, we talked about it, yeah, but it's a big leap financially. At least another 200 quid a week.
And she'd be losing her independence.
Well, do you think the news might have triggered her running away?
Quite possibly, yes. If she took it in.
Where's Mum?
Still in your grandmother's flat.
She's run away, hasn't she?
That's what we're trying to find out.
She don't know where she is half the time. None of them do.
Yeah, well, we've all got to get old one day.
I won't.
How's that then?
How's that then? Top myself when I'm full way.
Thanks. I'm over 40 myself.
I'd never have guessed.
All units from Sierra Oscar, 25 Formosa Gardens, suspect on premises.
Can anyone deal?
Take it.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra One, we'll take that, Polly.
Yeah, informant's the owner, Mrs. Marshall. She's waiting outside.
Received on way. Losing twos?
That might scare them off.
Thank you. I'd just picked up Oliver from his piano lesson. I turned the key in the lock when I heard someone moving about upstairs. My husband's abroad on business, so I knew it couldn't be him.
Has anyone else got a key?
No, it must be a break-in. All my jewellery's up there and everything.
Any other entrances around the back?
The back door and the French windows, but I locked them before I went out.
Right, Mrs. Marshall, can I have the keys, please, and just wait here. Hang on. Hey!
I'm going in first.
How come?
Family's edition. Why don't we try the back?
Whatever.
All right, don't move. Stay where you...
Hello, dear. I can't seem to find my earplugs.
What are you doing here?
I live here.
She says her name's Elvie Bright. She lives here, 25 Formosa Gardens.
I've never seen her before in my life.
Probably an Alzheimer's case on the run.
Yeah, how'd she get in here? All the doors are locked, like you said.
I haven't a clue.
How long you lived here, Mrs. Marshall?
Oh, about 2 years.
You ever changed the locks?
No, I don't believe we have.
I'll go and talk to her and get some sense out of her.
Yeah, you do that. She keeps on giving me some flannel about flock wallpaper.
Hello? It's Elvie, isn't it?
Yes, that's right.
Have you been to this house before?
This is my house, dear.
No, you're confused. This is Mrs. Marshall's house.
No, I'm not at all confused, dear. I've been here for over 40 years. See that tree? Ted planted that 20 years ago, the summer he retired. It was so hot, we wondered whether she'd survive. Well, she outlasted him.
This was your home, wasn't it, Elvie? You used to live here, didn't you?
Greenfly can't resist roses, can they?
The little blighters.
You'll be all right getting up here, love.
Will I have to make a statement?
Oh, I don't think that'll be necessary.
I had to make a statement the last time I was burgled.
Ah. Elvie, they found you.
Oh, you know her?
Yes, I do. Don't I, Elvie? We met this morning. Well, didn't you hear the Misper call?
I've been too busy to listen to the radio.
Where have you been, Elvie?
Nowhere. I've been at home all day.
Nick and old ladies for burglary, you must be getting desperate.
That our bag shall be under lock and key, if you'd ask me.
I bet you look a sight steaming into the bedroom with your ass about. The granny police.
I wouldn't be laughing out too loud if I was you. I'm in the car with your bird. Some of the things she's telling me about you, you wouldn't want people to know about them now, would you?
Well, it's par for the course, isn't it? Hell, that's no fury and all that.
You weren't her first choice, by all accounts.
Yeah, she wasn't exactly mine.
Working her way through the station, is she?
Fancy chances, do you?
Who says I'm interested in riding your old bike?
Yeah, well, you're welcome.
No, thanks. I don't scream coppers.
Why not? They moved, didn't they?
Right. How are you getting on with this?
All right. He speaks his mind. He's not whispering behind his hands like the others.
Yeah, but it's what's in his mind that bothers me.
I'd rather that than that two-faced chumminess from Tony.
Well, I know who I prefer to work with.
Des gets results. That's what we're here for, isn't it?
Yeah, but you don't have to come over all hard to get results, do you? And I thought me and you were making a change. You know, breaking out of our pigeonholes. You don't have to out-bloke the blokes.
No? Right. That's the advice I bear in mind.
A couple of us are going out clubbing tonight. Do you fancy it?
Well, I don't think I'd be very good company at the moment, Polly.
Look, Vic, I know you're feeling down, but you're in danger of isolating yourself from the rest of the relief.
So what? They don't like me, they never have.
Don't be stupid. You've just got to make a bit more of an effort, that's all.
Nah, I'll just bring everybody down the way I'm feeling.
All right, then. I'll see you back at the flat, yeah, after we finish work. You might have changed your mind by then. Go on, we'll have a laugh. We could get all dolled up together.
10 or 18 again.
Yeah, right.
I wish I really was 18 again.
You wouldn't do anything different.
Yes, I would.
Like what?
Everything.
You got a letter this morning, didn't you, Elvie? About the residential home.
Yes, I did.
Is that why you were so upset?
Yes, it's all very upsetting.
And you just wanted to go back and have a look at the old house?
Yes.
Well, how did you get there?
On the bus. Lots of people. Then when I got to the house, I felt so tired, I just had to lie down in my bed.
So you'd kept the keys?
I never wanted to sell the house, you know. But financially, when Ted died, there was no alternative, really. I know that.
I wouldn't believe a word she's telling you.
Sorry?
She knows exactly what she's doing, don't you, Mother?
I just wanted to see the house again, dear. That's all I could think about.
She makes a very convincing, dotty old lady, doesn't she? She's as sharp as any of us. How could you do this to me? As if I haven't got my hands full enough already with Nicole.
Don't go bringing me into this. It's not my fault, is it?
It certainly isn't, dear.
See?
I didn't say it was your fault.
Well, it sounds like you're blaming me. It's Granny who's under arrest, isn't it?
Nobody's under arrest here.
Well, she should be, for wasting police time. I should have told you earlier.
Tell me what?
The residential home. She's not trying to avoid it. She wants to go in there, don't you, Mother? You applied for a place, didn't you? Without telling me. She wants the luxury of full-time care.
You don't understand what it's like when you get to my age. You need help.
Oh, yeah. Help like hairdressing, bridge and music afternoons.
Why don't you just let me go there, dear? Then you wouldn't have to worry about me anymore.
You know why.
We can't afford it.
Well, can't the council help?
No.
Why not?
They say we've got to use the money from the sale of the house.
Well, that sounds reasonable enough.
She won't let me have the money, you see.
Oh, you control the money now.
Mother gave me power of attorney when she was ill 2 years ago, after Dad died.
And she's stolen it all.
I've kept the money so that I can afford to send Nicole to college.
Never have the stupid money. I don't want to go to college. I'm no good at school. You're always telling me how thick I am. I'd rather get a job anyway.
What, at the local supermarket on the till? You can do better than that.
You go to college if you're so keen.
I don't see why my mother should fritter away the family money in a residential home when she's still perfectly capable of looking after herself.
You sure about that?
Of course I'm sure. You think I don't know my own mother?
I've been noticing something since you've been in the car.
Oh yeah, what's that then?
Me and you, we're similar.
How do you mean?
In the way we approach the job.
Yeah, definitely.
And we should stick together, you know. Because they don't like us.
Who don't?
The others. Do you fancy a coffee?
I didn't take coffee breaks when I drove the area car.
Maybe that's why you lost it. All I'm saying is, people think I'm mad. Well, they do, don't they?
Yeah, they do, I suppose.
And because they think like that, that's the way I am. They might not appreciate it, but at least they know where they are. I give them what they want. But it doesn't mean to say I haven't got another side to me. Boyd might be clever with the words, but I've still got a heart.
I'm sure you have.
I just don't bring it to work with me. Can you appreciate that?
Of course.
Off duty, I'm a completely different person.
Really?
You'd like me.
I'm sure I would.
All units, here, Oscar. Staley Bridge Road, an assault.
Is that the old people's zone?
We're quite close.
Probably somehow Granny been savaged by a cat. Just relax and drink your coffee.
Elvie, did you see who did this to you?
A youth.
Can you describe him?
I didn't get much of a chance to look at him. He pushed me over, you see.
Was he white? Pale with fair hair.
Yeah.
Okay, Lance. All units from Sierra Oscar 2-1. Re the robbery suspect, Stalybridge Road area. I see one male. Pale skin, fair hair. Age about 17.
So the Martian turns around to him and he says, no problem. Have you got change of a suit?
Oh. Yeah, that's our little friend, isn't it?
You?
Me?
Yeah, you.
What have I done?
I don't know yet. Who was that you were talking to?
I don't know. I'd never seen him before. He just stopped and asked for a light.
Come on, who is he?
I told you, I don't know.
What's your name? I asked you a question.
Mother Teresa?
Right, we'll finish this at the station.
Mum, are you okay? What happened?
She was attacked on the road outside the house.
Third one today.
I knew I shouldn't have just left her there after the row we had. What could I do? I'm so sorry, Mum.
Your gran's lying in hospital, Nicole. Do you want to tell us what you know?
You don't expect us to believe you don't know anything about this. We saw you talking to the suspect.
Is gran gonna die?
No.
And what if she did? You'd have something on your conscience then, wouldn't you?
Yes.
You know that boy, don't you, Nicole? He's the one that knocked over your granny. You do know that, don't you?
He can't have done. I've been with him.
Then tell us who he is. Is he your boyfriend?
Sort of.
And that's the type of boyfriend you want, is it? One who knocks old grannies over?
I've seen him do it with my own eyes, Nicole. There's no point trying to protect him. But even if he didn't do your gran, I saw him hurt another old lady today. Why are you putting on this hard act? It's so obvious you're not like him.
I wanted Gary to like me. I never knew he was going to go down there and start knocking people over, did I?
So you were trying to impress him, yeah?
Shouldn't have told him about the booze and fags and that.
What booze and fags?
The ones the old folks are bringing over from abroad.
You were?
Those trips the warden takes them on to France. They went on one yesterday. That's what they're doing, bringing in lots of cheap booze and fags.
I think you better give us Gary Tanner's address. You don't want another load of old people ending up in the hospital because of him. Because if they do, it'll be down to you.
I can tell you where he's flogging the stuff.
Right. No messing about this time.
You go in, I'll take the runner.
Are you sure? You can't half run.
I'm sure.
Well, you better be.
£200 and a bottle of scotch, please, mate.
Down!
Get up!
Shut up!
You're hurting me.
Nice one, Lara.
Scrambled eggs, please. But I don't want the toast too well done. Thank you.
Elvie, we've nicked a lad who we think is doing the robberies.
That's good.
Now, he's admitted to the first two attacks today, but not to yours.
Oh.
In fact, he's got an alibi at the time that you were attacked. He was with your granddaughter.
With Nicole?
Yeah. Now, she's confirmed that. Now, we don't know whether she's telling the truth or covering for him, but she seems to be his girlfriend.
Be a bit of a coincidence, wouldn't it? Another muggy near Stalybridge House, but a different mugger.
I don't want Nicole getting into trouble over this. Nicole's boyfriend didn't attack me, Constable.
How can you be so sure?
Nobody attacked me. I did this to myself. It was the only way I could persuade Glynis about the rest home.
Elvie.
I knew you'd find out. You think I'm selfish, don't you? You're wrong, you know. I've waited on other people all my life. I deserve a rest. You won't tell her, will you? She'll be so angry with me.
So Glynis was right. You are putting on an act.
Thank you for letting me know about the clock, Constable.
Quick getaway, Des.
It's 10 o'clock. That's when I'm employed to.
We've got a hot date, have we?
That's for me to know and you to find out.
Thought I had a dog barking in the yard. Have fun.
I will. Don't worry.
So, we've been rumbled, have we?
Yeah. You're old enough to know better, though, aren't you?
Well, I knew it wouldn't last. You can't keep anything quiet for long in a place like this.
Well, we're not the first ones to find out. Why didn't you stop when you all became a local mugging target?
That's typical. Just because we're old, you think we're victims. We weren't going to let some snotty-nosed kid intimidate us. Anyway, it added to the fun.
Fun?
Yeah, even old codgers get adrenaline rushes. Made the rat run to the offie feel like being on a front line.
So you were supplying Mr. Hay?
He takes some of it off our hands, yes.
Well, just how many times have you been to France recently?
Ian takes us over about once a month. He thinks we just like the day out and the cheap booze.
And how many of the residents are involved?
Half a dozen, I suppose. Mind you, we do bring back booze and fags for the others. So it's more or less everybody, in one way or another.
You do realise that this is smuggling, don't you?
I prefer to call it a tax rebate.
Yeah, I bet you do.
Now, people of our age shouldn't have to pay purchase tax anyway. We were just taking back what we were owed. I mean, you spend your life paying tax, and what do you get as a reward? A pittance for a pension.
Yeah, but playing the Robin Hood of Sun Hill has led to the old ladies getting mugged on the street.
Nobody wanted that to happen. Listen. We were just out for a bit of adventure. Our way of feeling we're still alive.
Breaking the law so that you can feel alive. That's a new one on me.
So, what are you going to do? Chuck us all in jail?
Mr. Hay should be the worried one. New legislation's just increased the fine for avoiding duty.
You'll probably be all right. You might want to consider dipping into your extra tax rebate, though. Help Mr. Hay out. He's going to be seriously out of pocket, isn't he?
Bill.
Des, you made me jump.
Sorry. Didn't mean to start with you.
Thought you'd be long gone by now.
I waited for you.
Me? Why?
Well, I thought you might like to meet that Des. You know, the one we were talking about earlier. Off duty, Des. The one you said you'd like.
What do you mean?
Oh, come on. It's been going on in the car all day, hasn't it?
What has?
The vibe between us.
Des, there isn't a vibe between us.
You said yourself. We're on the same wavelength.
Yeah, and I meant working together, not...
I've got my car around the corner. Why don't me and you go back to mine and get things sorted out?
There's nothing to sort out.
Oh, isn't there?
Let go of me!
How come you're playing hard to get now and you were so easy with the others?
A good time, I'll be all right.
Well, you know where we are if you change your mind, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
See ya.
See you later.
So, have you seen anybody you fancy yet, Dave?
It's all groups of young lads, isn't it?
Some nice looking ones, though.
Do you reckon?
Yeah, those three over there, they're pretty fit.
Oh, they're looking over.
I thought this was supposed to be a girls' night out.
Yeah, well, it doesn't mean we can't try someone for size, does it?
Oi, Vicky's here.
I didn't know if she was coming.
Who invited her?
Well, I did, actually. You know, I thought it might cheer her up after everything she's been through.
Oh, great. We're going to have a really fun night with her jumping down everyone's throats.
Hello, everyone.
Hello,
everyone. Not too late for the action, am I? All right, come on, then. Have you phoned anybody up yet?
Oh, not yet. We've got some serious interest on table six.
Is that it? Is that the best you can do?
Oh, come on, Vic. We're just having a laugh.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It's been a long time since I had any. No, come on, then. I'll tell you what. I'll buy you all a drink. What are you having?
Port and lemon. I think I'll have a warm wine.
Oh, can I have the same again, please?
Yeah, me too.
Two double vodka cokes, two white wine spritzes, and a port and lemon.
Oh, you changed your mind then?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Glad you did. You don't want to put yourself out on a limb with the others.
I'm not here for them, Polly, am I? I'm here for the men.
Cheers! How did you get on with Des today, Vic?
Ah. Yeah, no problem.
Because you've got to watch these scouse men, you know, they're like squirrels after nuts.
What men aren't.
Yeah, who's complaining?
You will be soon enough.
Cheers, Vic. Come on, wasn't we going to find someone?
I thought the idea was they rung us.
Oh, don't be so old-fashioned. Yeah, you've got to get stuck in there these days, haven't you, Buzz?
Yeah, well, I still do like the man to make the first move.
Do you?
Yeah, well, then I know he likes me.
Oh,
yeah. But don't you wish you could go up to a bloke in the club, look him up and down, you know, the way they do with us?
Yeah, and go, you all right, darling? You with anyone? Do you mind if I sit here, love?
I'll drink love.
Basically means I'll buy you as many vodka and coke as you like, as long as you let me screw you afterwards.
Yeah!
And then they do. And they say, oh, I've got to go home now. I've got work in the morning. I've got to get the last tube. Give me a ring any time. Here's my mobile number, which invariably means I've got a wife and kid at home, and there's usually a digit missing from it anyway.
Thanks. Don't lock, don't lock.
Oh, do ya? Right. No, I've got blonde hair. Oh, no, sorry, mate, you must have the wrong table. We're table 8. Yeah, I'm the one in the red. You are? Don't talk to me like that, you cheeky get. That is the competition sorted.
You're terrible.
Yeah, no, well, that's what it's all about, isn't it?
Hi, ladies.
Hello.
Hi.
You having a good time?
Yeah, not bad. Yeah. Yeah.
Come on, what do you all do for a living?
Well, I'm a lap dancer.
Gonna give it a demonstration then?
I'm afraid it's my night off.
What about the rest of you? What do you do?
Oh, I'm a chimney sweep.
Crane driver.
I'm a police woman.
Yeah,
police. Honestly, do you want to see the handcuffs?
Same. Thank you.
Two double vodkas and a bottle of Coke, please.
Vicky.
Rob.
So, you're not phoning anybody then?
Nah, it's not really my thing.
I mean, it's a bit naff, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
I'd much rather talk directly.
Would you?
If I feel there's a bit of a vibe.
So if you're not into phones then, why exactly are you here?
Well, I've come here to meet you, haven't I?
All right, so now what then?
What about your place?
No, I live right on the other side of London.
All right.
You got somewhere?
Might have.
Yeah.
All right.
Hello.
Vicky left.
Yeah, she went off with some bloke at the bar.
She didn't waste much time.
Yeah, her man hating play didn't last long, did it?
Needs the ego boost, I expect.
Well, at least he's not a copper, right? Yeah,
that's true.
Yeah, right.
It's a nice place, isn't it?
Right, get this down, your pole. You're supposed to be showing us what you're made of tonight.
Yeah, what's up with you, Paul? I mean, look at the arse on that.
Oh, please, I'm not a cradle snatcher. And anyway, there's only three of them, there's four of us.
Yeah, we can always take it in turns.
Or we could upgrade. Right, what table do you want?
Yeah, you go, Paul.
Two or three?
Two.
Two. Two it is.
I don't know.
Don't you like me?
Yeah. No.
Am I doing something wrong?
No.
What then?
I just can't.
Why not?
Tonight, I don't know.
What?
I don't know.
What?
I don't know. I can't.
Perfect end to a perfect day.
I can't help it.
No.
No, I'm not talking about you. It's all right. I'm talking about me. I can't even get this right. I'm trying to have a one-night stand. Ends up being a one-night flop. Oh, I didn't mean you. I'm not talking.
No, it's okay. I know exactly what you meant.
I'm 5'10" and I've got blonde hair. Yes. I've got pink handcuffs as well. Oh, come on, girls. I can't have all three of them on my own.
No, you surprise me. You know what? I think I'm going to shoot off, Di.
Polly, is that dessert us now? Come on, just one more drink, please.
Yeah, one more.
Come on, please. Just one.
Yay!
A little one.
You know what, Di? I'm really going to have to go now.
What about those blokes?
You're welcome to them.
No, I mean, how are we going to get rid of them?
That's not my problem. And anyway, Roz and Kez look like they wanted to stick around. I'll see you tomorrow, yeah?
Yeah, all right. See ya.
See ya.
See ya.
Next on The Bill.
If you're stupid enough to go to bed with a complete stranger, Vicky,
your officers have been causing trouble.
I'm never going to be able to go back to my flat now because of you.
You killed her. I hope you rot in hell.